Welcome back, boys and girls,
to AIA Online PE.
Today is Monday, April 13th, 2020.
We sure hope that you had a fabulous weekend and a happy Easter. And we sure hope you're ready for this workout routine and this stretching routine. And always do your best.
And we sure hope you had, don't forget, we also had a good Friday too. So hopefully you had a good Friday as well, all right? And had a restful weekend. Because, you know, always take breaks every now and then. Don't always work out too consistently, pressure your body too much. It's good to have a little break and rest for your body so your muscle can develop again and rebuild itself, okay? Also, right now, you see again, we're outside again. For this another PE session, workout session. So it's good to be outside every now and then. Don't always stay in one spot all the time. And luckily, the sun is out today. You know, sometimes it's good to have some sun in our body because the sun give us vitamin D. So, Coach, how does vitamin D help?
Well, Coach, it develops and enhances your bones. You got to have strong bones to complete any task or any physical task that's given to you. So that vitamin D you must intake and grow that bone structure.
Another thing I want to add on to it is you can also get vitamin D from drinking a lot of milk, but the sun is more of a way for natural vitamin D. Sometimes it's good to have some natural vitamin D besides just drinking milk. So always, every now and then, go outside. Don't trap yourself inside all the time. It's good to be outside. And even though we're going through a pandemic right now, all this crisis going on, we shouldn't be out too much. But as long as you're away from people and you're outside, or open space, and get some, it's good because you need some fresh air, okay? Just get outside, get some vitamin D, get some sunlight. Don't always stay inside, all right, boys and girls? But other than that, we'll start our workout now and our routine, so we'll see you in a bit.
All right, boys and girls, now before we begin our stretching routine, our workout routine, and our cool down, make sure you have ample amount of space like we do right, like you see in the video right now, boys and girls. Make sure you got ample space, that you have enough room to stretch so you do not injure yourself. Okay, Coach Tran is going to demonstrate a stretching routine, a workout routine, and a cool down, and that will develop and enhance your cardiovascular endurance, your lower body strength, and your overall flexibility. Welcome back, boys and girls. We are now going to start our stretching routine, and me and Coach Tran are going to demonstrate the neck rotation.
The neck rotation. All right, boys and girls. The neck rotation is a simple movement in your neck. Only your neck should be moving. What I like to do preferably is have my hands on my hips and you circle your neck. All you're doing is circling your neck in circles, rotating it in circles, one neck direction, okay? We're going to do it for 10 times. Okay, we'll count to 10. And let's get started, boys and girls. Ready, set, go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right, now the other way, opposite direction.
Opposite direction.
Ready, set, go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
It's always good, don't forget, boys and girls, to loosen up the muscle. So right now we're trying to loosen the muscle in the neck area, okay, of our body part. So we're on to the next stretch, Coach.
Toe touches.
Okay. So standing toe touch, all you're gonna be doing is gonna be reaching for your toes. Stay straight. Make sure when you do it, both legs are straight. Do not bend your leg. Do not bend your leg or anything. Always make sure it's straight and touch your toe. You can't touch your toe yet, try to reach for it. That's why it's called toe touch. Go as far as low as you can. If it's too easy, use your elbows, try to touch your toes. Make it more harder for you. Okay, so real quick, this is how it looks. This is how it should be looking right now. And it's on the side view. All right, boys and girls, all right, let's get started. We're gonna try to reach for our toe. We're gonna hold it for 15 seconds. All right, ready, set, go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
All right, boys and girls, good. Hope you guys feel that stretch in your legs and your hamstring, because today we're going to be doing some lower body workout. Okay, what's the next stretch, Coach?
Next one we got to do is the seated leg crossover.
Seated leg crossover, okay. This one can require you to sit down. Right now me and Coach are outside, we'll be in the cement area, but make sure you guys are sitting on the cushion area. Okay, you're going to make sure you're safe first, okay? Don't risk your life or anything for doing all this stuff. Make sure you're in a safe spot, open area, before you do it, okay? Mm-hmm. It's not gonna injure yourself, but just make sure your body is not getting hurt. So what you wanna do is you wanna sit down, you're gonna sit down on your bottom. And then we're gonna cross our leg over. Doesn't matter which side, but I'm gonna do my right side or my left side, okay? This is my right side over here. My leg over my left.
Right side.
So we'll cross like this. Oh. That's how you should be seated right now.
Oh, just like that with my left leg can't bring that over.
Look. Both of you, if you guys can't do this yet, it's okay. Just try to do your best. Like how coach is doing right now. No one's perfect trying to get it in the first time. So take your time, slowly get to it, stretch it out. Once you guys get into it, it should be a lot easier. So keep stretching, okay, boys and girls? Flexibility is very important.
Well, you can tell.
Okay, so right over left. So what you're gonna do here is you're gonna lean forward. Once you have your legs crossed over, you're gonna lean forward. That's all you're doing. We're gonna count 10 seconds, okay? Ready? Set, go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
All right, now we're gonna switch sides. So now it's gonna be my left leg over my right leg. We're gonna do both directions, both sides. Okay?
There we go.
All right, you ready, coach?
I'm ready.
All right, let's go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
All right, boys and girls, that was the leg cross stretch. Okay, we're stretching out our quad muscle when we're doing that. So keep it up, and let's go on to our next stretching routine.
You're seated number four reach.
Seated number four reach. So it's a simple seated number four reach. Okay, I think I did before on our first video for the seated number four reach, but this time we're gonna make a little more advanced seated number four reach. What you're gonna be doing is have both legs straight out first. All right. So I'm gonna stretch out my left leg side leg first. So I'm gonna do is have my right side leg, make it number four, cross over my left leg. So it's on top of my left leg. So you see the number four right here? This is how it should look. So make it number four with your leg. Now you're gonna reach for your toe, okay? Now try to have your body lean forward and reach for your toe. You should feel the stretch in your hamstring, your calf muscle, everything. Stretch out that leg muscle because we're gonna do some lower body workout. That's why we're focusing on our legs today. All right, now we're gonna do it for 10 seconds. Ready, set, go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
All right, switch sides. Right down, left over right. Make it number four, don't forget. All right, reach for your toe. Count 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All right.
Yeah, and boys and girls, always remember when you're engaged in a stretching routine that you have body control. You don't need to be moving a whole lot around. Just stay in one spot and focus on that one spot while you're stretching.
Yes. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Always stretch first before you go into the workout. Increase your flexibility. If you're flexible, you can do a lot of things. Right, coach?
Exactly. Just like Coach Tran, very flexible.
All right, let's move on to our workout routine now, boys and girls.
Welcome back, boys and girls. Now we're going to start our workout routine. Boys and girls, make sure that you do your best and follow me and Coach Tran, okay?
Stay consistent, all right? You won't get stronger from here. Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to start with is marching. We're going to march for 30 seconds, all right? Make sure that when we're marching, we swing our arms forward and backward, and you get those knees up high.
Yes, back and forth, knees up high. So a quick demonstration. Swing your arm. Usually, also, you got the force here, you can see, it's opposite leg and opposite arm raising up, swinging up at the same time. Opposite. It's not the same side, no. Opposite. Okay? Just put a quick side view. Alrighty. So, we're gonna do that 15 times, coach?
30 seconds.
Oh, 30 seconds.
30 seconds.
Oh, since we have a timer on us, we're gonna do. Oh, we have a timer, coach?
I can put mine on, yes, sir.
Oh, alright. Got his phone. We'll put a 30 second timer for us to do the marching, okay? We're gonna march back and forth for 30 seconds. This is gonna build your leg muscle, your flexibility, okay? And your coordination. Because you know, when you're doing this on the opposite side, you're also building your coordination.
Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta remember that it's the opposite direction, opposite leg and arms. Mm-hmm. Okay?
All right, you ready, coach?
Yes.
All right.
Let's begin, boys and girls. Ready?
One, two, three, begin.
Go. Just follow the clock. Back and forth. March. March.
March.
Opposite. March. March. Like you're marching.
Swing those arms.
Yeah, swing it. Put some movement into it. It's a little quick warm up for the muscle.
Those knees up high when you're marching.
Yes, especially if boys and girls, you want to do the marching band in high school. They'd be marching the football field.
Exactly.
March, march, march.
Oh, there you go.
That's 30 seconds, boys and girls.
All right. Next on the agenda, boys and girls, we are going to engage in our straight jumps.
Straight 15. Jump. 15. So just like the previous video that you guys have been seeing for the straight jump, before a quick overview of the straight jump, real quick review, is when you do a straight jump, you're going to jump as high as you can, and then you're going to have your arms pull back, bend your knees slightly, then you're going, once you go up, you're going to jump up and swing your arm up, okay? Move your arm up, and jump up as high as you can. We do 15 times. All right, boys and girls. Ready? Set? Go! One.
One.
Two. Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Six.
Six.
Seven.
Seven.
Eight.
Eight.
Nine.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
11.
12.
12.
13.
13.
14.
14.
15. All right, boys and girls, that's the straight jump. We're going to get explosiveness and your cardiovascular endurance.
Yes.
All right, move on to the next workout.
All right. Builds that lower body strength too.
Yep, you're right, coach.
Yes, it does. All right, boys and girls, we're gonna move on to calf raises. Calf raises. We're gonna do 15 calf raises.
All right, for a little quick review of the calf raises real quick. Don't forget, boys and girls, this right here behind your leg right here, the calf muscle right here. So when you're doing the calf raising, you're building this muscle right here, this muscle part right here, okay?
Right there. Sit.
Yeah, coach, sneeze. Hey, if I have long pants and I can't really see mine, he's wearing shorts, so you can see his calf muscle. That's what you're going to be building, okay? Build an overall body, okay?
So, yes.
So calf raises, you're going to be on your toes, sitting on your tippy toes, and you come back down. Make sure you don't go flat on your feet. You go back and up and down, up and down, okay? Do it 15 times. And towards the end, we're going to hold it for 20 counts. All right, boys and girls?
What are those calf raises? What are they developing in the handsome coach?
When you're doing those calf raises, you're building your muscle, your calf muscle, which is the reason why you want strong calf muscle is usually the calf muscle is usually what helps you jump higher. Okay? And plus, it looks, to me, it looks good. I don't know how you boys view a calf muscle, but when you have a strong leg, every section of your leg is built, it looks good. So that's why we work on each part of our body to make sure it's built and looks good.
Yes, indeed.
All right, coach.
Excellent. Very good, coach.
All right, so we're going to get your toes. Do it 15 times. Do it 15 times, and we'll hold it at the end for 20 seconds, for 20 counts, okay? Ready, set, go. One.
One.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
12.
13.
14.
15.
16.
17.
Oh,
my bad.
Oh, yes.
I forgot. My bad. But now, okay, don't forget. Hold it. Now stay on your tippy toes as high as you can and count 20. Ready, set, go. 1,
2,
3,
4,
5,
6,
7,
8,
9,
10,
11,
12,
13,
14,
15,
16,
17,
18,
19,
20.
All right, it's good to hold that calf raise because you're doing your muscle and building your balance on your tippy toes, right, coach?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right.
Build that calf muscles.
All right, boys and girls, we're going to move on to the next workout routine.
Also, if you build those calf muscles, if you're interested in ever playing basketball, it's very important to make sure that you've got a good lower body strength is built, those calf muscles, because in basketball, you use those to jump and move. That's very important. So you'll see a lot of basketball players do those calf raises.
That's right. That's right, coach. A lot of basketball players have strong calf muscles. It's built, as you can see, with the legs.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes. All right, next on the agenda is the side-to-side jump.
Side-to-side.
Okay, side-to-side jumps.
Usually, when you are doing the side-to-side jump, you want to have an object so you can mark where you're jumping across. But right now we're outside, this is really messy, no object we have to go jumping across. But if you guys have one, go ahead and use it, jump across each side to side, okay? But for us, we're going to do a regular jump side to side. So a quick demonstration, you're going to jump side to side. It's like doing a straight jump, but you're not going as high up as you can, but you're just going side to side. We're going to do it. 10 on each side.
10 on each side.
All right.
Just like we would be out at PE if we were on the blacktop, boys and girls, we always jump what? The yellow line.
Oh, there we go, coach. There we go. There we go. So we're going to do just like how me and coach, when we do like the hula hoop. We tell you jump in, jump out, jump across. It's like kind of similar to that.
So.
Okay, but this time we're going to do side to side consistently. All right, real quick demonstration. boom, 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 boom. Right, and then a quick side beat. Boom. All right, we're gonna do 10 on each side. So a total of 40 count. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
All righty. How you
feel? I feel good.
I feel good. It's good to be outside.
What we're doing, we're developing
and we're enhancing our lower body strength, our overall balance, our balance, our lower body strength, and any sport that requires you to have good lower body strength, like for instance basketball or running, track, for instance, football, most definitely, most sports that involve running and jumping a lot require you to have good lower body strength. And that's why we're doing the calf raises.
Yes.
That's why we're doing the side-to-side jumps.
Yes.
And so we can build that lower body strength, those calf muscles.
There we go, Coach. I understand now, Coach. All right, now we're going to move on to the last workout of the routine. It's the reverse
lunges.
Okay. So last week, we taught you the front lunges. Now we're going to teach the reverse lunges.
Reverse lunges.
So reverse means you're going to go backwards. That's what reverse means, going backwards. So it's similar to a lunge, but this time you're going to be stepping backwards instead of forward, okay? So yes. Quick demonstration.
Now step out and let Coach demonstrate the reverse lunge.
All right, Coach. All right, you're going to stand still here. You go back to a lunge position. Then you step back up. And other foot, other leg, same thing. Back. Okay. Make sure your bottom foot, your knees almost touch the ground, but it's not, and you're on your toes. Okay. And this one, the front leg is flat. The foot's flat and steady. All right. Quick side view. All right. We'll do 10 reverse lunges on each leg. All right, boys and girls, get ready. Use the side so you see better. Ready, set, go. 1, 2.
Look how Coach Tran is on his knee, on his toes.
4.
When he goes back, he's 5, on his toes.
6. 7. 8. 9.
Knees almost touching the ground.
11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19, 20. All right, those are the reverse lunges, okay? So overall, we're working on your lower body strength. That was our first set. Get that 1 minute water break, stay hydrated. We'll see you guys in a bit for the second set, okay?
Peace.
I just wanna rollie, rollie, rollie with a dapper ranch. I already got some.
Okay, all right, both girls, welcome back to our second set. Hope you guys got that water break.
Yes. Got some water in me.
So, you
got to keep yourself hydrated. You want to be able to have enough energy to make it through the workout. You want to replenish your body with fluids.
Yes, very important. Especially when you're like me, I sweat a lot. So, yes. All my fluids out my body is leaving my body. So, it's not good when your body is like empty on fluids. So that's why you got to drink water to replenish. I mean soda, sugar drink, all that stuff might be fluid too, liquid water. But it's not good for you. You want something that's good for you. So water is one of the best drinks you ever drink in this entire world. All right? Water's everywhere. So drink a lot of water. Stay hydrated. Let's move on to our second set.
Yeah.
We're going straight into it. No pauses. All right, boys and girls, just finish strong.
Finish strong. Finish strong.
With the marching.
Marching.
Away from coach.
30 seconds.
Away from coach. Start the clock. 30 seconds.
All right. It's nice and bright out here.
Sir.
All right.
Let's start, boys and girls.
Begin.
Go! March, march, march. Opposite. Coordinate your body. March. Put your knees up as high as you can. Open your arms. Put some movement into it.
Put some movement. Swing those arms.
Yeah. March, march. March like soldiers. March. All right, that was the clock. All righty, now we're gonna move on to the straight jump.
Straight jump.
All right, ready, 15, ready, set, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Woo! All right. Next workout will be the side to side jump, boys and girls, in the calf raises.
All right, side to side, okay, boys and girls.
Side to side jump.
All right, ready? Go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Woo!
How you feeling, coach?
Good.
All right, coach. All right, feel a burn. That's good. Feel a burn. That means it's working.
Yes. All right, moving on to the calf raises. All right, boys and girls, get ready. 20 times.
20.
I mean, come on, 15. It went over 20. Set, go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
All right, hold it, 20 count, ready, set, go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Woo!
I feel it, coach.
I feel it. Coach, you got one more workout routine?
I feel it. Oh. If you do this workout, when you do this workout on Monday, if you do it outside, if it's good weather, you'll feel, if you feel the burn, you feel you're getting tired, that means it's working.
That's right. No pain, no gain.
Yeah. Pain, no gain.
If it hurts, not. If it hurts, it works.
All right.
All right. Last routine.
Reverse lunges.
Ready, boys and girls?
A little CC.
Set. Go. Four, should I really even start? I got that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps wasn't facts, so they sat with the bars. 12.
I got two phones, one 13. Need a charge. Yeah, they 14. Chance, I can tell it apart.
15.
I got big packs coming 16. On the way. I got big 17. Stacks coming out to save.
18.
Got Lil Max with me, he the way. It's a big gap
20.
Between us and the game.
All right, both girls.
In the next life, we're trying to
crunches,
stay paid.
Give me lunges.
When I die,
good job, you finished through. That was the second set. I'll see you guys in a bit. Get that water break, stay hydrated. Really, and I'll see you for the last set. Hey, we're going to finish strong, boys and girls.
Woo!
Really on my face. Lil CC, let it slap with the bass. I used to save.
All right, boys and girls, welcome back.
Welcome back.
This is our last set of the workout. Hopefully, you guys had a good water break as well. We're tired, but we got pushed through.
Yes, yes.
Coach.
I feel good, though.
You're good, coach.
Feel good.
It's always good to sweat.
Yes.
It's always good to sweat. You have all that body with these days.
Those impurities.
Impurities, yes. All that thick stuff in your body. All the time you've been sitting down. All that food you've been digesting. This is like a good workout to digest.
Yes.
Least the stuff, all the toxins in your body.
Yes.
Right, move on to the workout. All right, boys and girls, ready? Marching, 30 seconds, ready?
30 seconds. Yeah.
Go. One.
One.
All right,
two.
No count, no count. 30 seconds.
That's right.
March.
My time, bro.
March, boys and girls, march.
Knees up.
Opposite. Side view.
Side view.
Look, just another state case. Very mind, but Chase Bank trying to
pass. How you feel, coach?
Feeling good.
All right.
Make sure you have body control when you're doing this.
March. Dripping like I got a zillion dollars, got the truck jumping like Zane when I rebound, then I'm out. All right, that was the clock, boys and girls. Hope you guys got that march in. All right, moving on to the straight jump. 15. All right, you ready, coach?
I'm ready.
Let's go, boys and girls. Go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right.
All right, how you feeling?
Feeling good, coach.
All right, coach, good.
All right, side to side jump now. Ready? 10 on each side.
10 on each side.
40 to the count. Ready, set, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15,
16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Woo, woo.
Calf raises, 15, all right.
Calf raises.
Ready, go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
All right. Who am I cast
feeling?
All right. Alright, last workout routine. Reverse lunge.
Reverse lunge.
Alright, boys and girls, ready? Reverse lunge. Ready, set, go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Woo! All right.
All right.
We've been doing the whole workout without stopping. Do the workouts. Good job. Keep it up. Get that one last bit of water break. They would have cooled down. Water in there. All right, coach, how you feel, coach?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good, actually. It's good to get out in the outside today, get out here in the sun, and soak in that vitamin D. Make sure that those muscles get strong, because remember, whatever sports you want to engage in, whether it be basketball, football, track,
yes,
got to build. We focused on our what, coach, today? Our
lower body strength.
Lower body strength.
That's good. It's good to have a good foundation, okay? Always good. No matter how advanced you are, everybody starts somewhere, right, coach?
Yes. Practice makes perfect. The first time you try something, it's always going to be the hardest.
Yes, correct. That's correct.
Once you get used to a routine, it becomes easier.
Be like clockwork. But now, both girls, see you in a bit.
Magic in the air. Head to toe, so clear. like, ooh, so bad. Everywhere I go, they be like, ooh, so bad. Everywhere I go, they be like, ooh, so bad. Nah, watch me break it down like, ugh. 24 karat. What's that sound? 24 karat. Come on now. 24 karat. 24 karat magic. Don't fight the feeling, invite the feeling. Just put your
did for you and why it's important to do these certain workouts for each workout, okay? All right, so the first workout we did was the marching.
Coach, marching.
Why did we do the marching? What was the purpose of marching?
So we can develop our overall balance, our overall coordination, and our lower body strength. Because when you march, and in your cardiovascular endurance, because when you're marching, you're constantly using that lower body. So those are what you develop when you were marching. It's always very good to engage in marching. If you're sitting down, get up, stretch a little bit, march a little bit, so we can develop that what? Lower body strength.
Lower body strength, that's correct. That was the focus on for today, right? So the next workout we did was the straight jump.
Straight.
So what was the purpose of the straight jump, Coach? What did it work on?
Straight jump developed and enhanced our calf muscles.
Okay.
It also developed our balance and our calf muscles, like I said earlier. And our cardiovascular endurance and our overall body, our overall coordination.
Okay, all right, Coach, that's good. And also I want to add on, when we do the straight jump, like I said, it's an explosive movement. Because you're jumping as high as you can, you're pretty much using all your energy to jump as high as you can. That's why it's called an explosive movement. So that's why it's a good way to do like cardiovascular, for cardiovascular endurance in your lower body, because you're exerting a lot of force to go up. Okay, so that's why doing the straight jump is good workout overall for the body. So you can trick your body besides just doing like the marching, it's like a little slight cardio. But when you're doing the straight jump, you're exerting more energy and force.
Yes.
That's why you get more tired easily when you do the straight jump compared to the march.
Okay, very good explanation, Coach Trent.
All right, appreciate it, Coach. And the next workout we did was the side-to-side jump. What was the purpose of the side-to-side jump, Coach?
Develop our cardiovascular endurance, our lower body strength, our calf muscles, and our overall coordination.
That's correct, Coach. That's correct. Especially when you have an object in the middle between you, you're jumping over across, you gotta make sure when you jump, you don't touch the object, right? But now we don't have no object, so we don't have really anything to help label us to where we're supposed to jump over across, okay? So that's why it's good to coordinate your body. That's why Coach said it's an overall coordination, because you coordinate your body from jumping from one side to the other side without like messing up, without touching the object, if you have an object between you guys.
Okay. Right, exactly. Like during PE, Coach, we have that activity with the hula hoop, and they gotta jump in and jump out. Yes. And sometimes they gotta also listen. Remember, if we tell them to jump in, and if they jump out, and they do the opposite of what we say, then they're out. That's why me and Coach, and that's why we teach those certain activities, so you can develop that overall coordination.
Yes.
You know, so and those listening skills, but all you can do is what you can do at home, so that's all we expect.
Yes. And the next workout routine was the calf raise. What was the purpose of the calf raise, Coach?
Calf raise is, again, develop and enhance those calf muscles, lower body strength, your overall coordination, and your balance.
That's correct. Especially when you're holding it on your tippy toes at all times. That requires a lot of balance, because sometimes people will like lose balance and they will like move, they'll stumble. So that's why you gotta make sure your hold stand straight up, and you're out moving, and stay on your toes the whole entire time. That requires a lot of balance.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
And next workout, last workout we did was the reverse lunge.
Reverse lunge.
What did the reverse lunge do for you, Coach?
That developed and enhanced your lower body strength, your calf muscles, your balance. And because if you saw how Coach Tran was demonstrating, his knee was almost touching the ground, so that required a lot of balance when you were doing the reverse lunge. He was on his toes when he was doing the reverse lunge. A lot of body control. So most definitely, the reverse lunge develop and enhances your body control, your lower body strength, your calf muscles, and your overall coordination.
That's correct. And also, like I said, for the last week, you want to do the front lunge or the side lunge, it's also developing your hamstring part of the muscle section of your leg. And however, forget behind the thighs right here, the whole overall thighs. The front side is the quadricep muscles, and the back side is the hamstrings. So when we do the lunges, we're more focusing on the hamstring because we put more pressure on it when we do the lunges. That's another part, reason why we do the lunges, is to focus on different body part of the legs, okay? Different muscle part of the legs, besides just one whole area, okay? So always work out, continue on working out hard. Always, don't ever give up, stay active, eat healthy, and you will get far. Trust
yes.
me. Right, coach?
Most definitely. And with those, back on with the reverse lunges, it works those hamstrings. And if you ever want to be a football player, a lot of the exercises that the coaches will teach you are those, the reverse lunge, the forward lunge, a lot of the lunges. You'll see a lot of the football players doing lunges. Why? Because they want to build those hamstrings, because you got to be fast and on your toes, especially for wide receivers. If you get going up for a pass, you got to stay on your toes and keep your balance. That's why you see a lot of the football coaches, they teach those reverse lunges, those forward lunges, because it builds and develops that lower body and those quadriceps and those hamstrings, because those parts of your body, those muscles have to be strong.
That's correct, coach. That's correct. All right, boys and girls.
All right, boys and girls.
Thanks for watching AIA Online PE. Hope you guys had a good workout session today. And don't forget, always, always stay active. Be healthy, eat correctly. If you might find it. It's repetitive all the time, like we say it all the time, but we say it for a reason. We say it for a reason because we want you guys to be healthy.
Yes.
That is our first priority, to make sure you guys stay healthy. As a PE coach here, we want you guys to get strong, do the best you can be, and be the best version of yourself every day, okay?
You're not gonna be nobody's perfect, but you can try to always do your best. And a lot of the exercises we did today, if you're sitting in front of the TV at home, a lot of the exercises and the workout routine that we demonstrated today, you can stand up in front of your couch and do. But just make sure you got a nice cushioned area, and you can jump side to side, do the reverse lunges, do the calf raises, do marching. A lot of those are stationary
workouts.
So you don't have to have a whole lot of space, but they're stationary workouts. So if you're sitting in front of that TV, get up and try those exercises when you get in front of that TV. Just get up and do it you can do it when you're watching TV. Get up, do marching, march, stand, jump in place. Be active.
All the workout we teach you guys requires barely any movement from your area. So that's why we do teach you all your stationary workouts, because you can work out literally anywhere you want.
Yes, Coach Trent. Most definitely.
Yes. But in that, boys and girls, don't forget, stay active and be healthy. All right. We see you guys tomorrow.
Peace.